Hi, I'm Char Crail, and this is Focus on Creativity. I'm a photographer, an artist, and a muse, and that's my conversation, is creativity. I love talking to people who want to talk to me about creativity. I mean, what more can I say about that? And tonight we are talking to Steve Mahoney, who is a singer, songwriter, he's a musician. He may be an intensely prolific songwriter. My gosh, I think he's probably written over 2,000. Of course, they don't always make it into print, as he says, or into the band necessarily. But he's here today with us, and we're going to find out how his process works. Hi, Steve.
Hi, how are you?
Very well, thank you. So how does your process work, Steve? Why don't you just tell us, sort of give us an overview of yourself as a musician, singer, songwriter, dude.
The focus being on creativity. So there's two main thrusts to what I do, and that's the prepared part and then the inspiration part. So the prepared part is making sure you have all the right tools, and the tools are easy to access. That is, I can't show you here, but maybe I can. I'll bring it around. There's a little teeny tiny little...
Oh, Pro Tool. Is that Pro Tools?
This is a little audio interface. It's not necessarily for Pro Tools, but I have a Focusrite Scarlett.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Yeah, upside down. This is a pretty simple one. There's an input for a guitar, an input for a microphone. Two. That's all you need. It costs $100. There's some speakers on either side here, some pretty nice monitors. And I'm talking to you on my iMac. I also have one of these things.
So is digital in your home like this really changed?
So I think for working at home, I have these tools. Everything's plugged in. There's always a guitar that's plugged into that interface, and there's a program that's set up. And I have, for really fast ideas, I use GarageBand. I know a lot of people down GarageBand a lot, but it's so fast. It's the easy thing to get the idea down. Other programs are cool, and I use other programs. I won't talk about those right now. But let's just say that GarageBand is super easy, and that's why I like to get ideas quickly.
So is that a piece of software that you use?
GarageBand, I already set up a template, so it's got everything I want. 1, 2, 3, 4, I got drums, guitar, bass drum. Everything's already there, so I just have to pick what I'm going to start with. 95% of the time, I start with guitar. So as a guitar player most of my life, it's always guitar riffs. So it's always some crazy, this thing's out of tune, so I'm going to play it. I just sit down and start playing, but the part about being prepared is to have the tools ready to go. And so if I'm not in front of a computer, then I have one of these. I have an iPhone. And even in the old days, I used to carry around one of those little micro cassette recorders.
Yeah.
Right? And I can't hear you anymore. Are you still there?
I am still here.
Oh, and you can't... There you go. Okay.
Okay.
And anyway, So even if I wasn't in front of something that I could necessarily capture, I could take my little phone and be like, okay, here's a song. Da, 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 da. And then I listen back to it later and go, what the hell was that garbage? So the idea is if you can capture it, right? So that's the big hurdle, capturing it. And then you've got your idea in some tangible form. Even if you don't finish it, I encourage all songwriters to, whatever they've got, no matter what time of day or night it is, because it's always inevitably 3 o'clock in the morning when everybody else is asleep, and your mind starts to go into that pre-dreaming zone, you know?
Yeah.
There's nothing else to worry about. Now all of a sudden your creative mind is opened up, and you're going to go, in bed you're going to go, I'm going to remember this in the morning.
No.
It's not going to happen.
No.
You know?
Get up, get it down.
Go to the other room, get it done. You're going to sacrifice your work. You're going to sacrifice your family. That's the muse, man. You got to see.
Oh, I love that. So do you keep your iPhone or your iPad by the bed? Or do you actually get up and go and make music?
It's under my pillow. But I,
oh, wow.
Because this is my studio. It's in the middle of reconstruction. I don't know if you can see this, but. There's a bunch of guitars sitting on the ground in cases right there.
Nice.
Probably about 10 on the ground right there. And we've got these cool things over here. I think you can see.
Oh, yeah.
There's some slats over there laying on the ground. And they are wall hangers like you see at the guitar store.
Oh, right.
These ones are custom, though. I won't go into that. But anyway, I'm going to mount onto the wall. Each one can hold 9 guitars. I've got 3 of them, so do the math.
Nice.
Almost 30 guitars are going to be hanging on these walls here.
And you have 30 guitars?
No, but we're going to get there.
Wow. How many do you have?
I'll say 19.
19.
I don't know.
And I believe, and I'm sure that there's a reason, because they probably each have their own personality. Is that why 19, or why so many? Why would you need so many?
Why not? I don't know.
Well, I believe in why not too. I totally get that, but why would you pick one guitar over another?
I don't have any kids. I have guitars.
They're your children? Okay, got it.
We have a dog.
God, and he can't play guitar, so you know.
Well, no, she's just my producer now. You know, she'll sit down, make sure I'm on track. But no, I don't know. Some of them are tuned differently. So like this guitar, these first two guitars right here, they're tuned to one tuning. The rest of these sitting on the stand right here are acoustics. But the white one in the background is tuned to a different tuning than these two.
Yeah.
Some of the ones in the casers are tuned to different tunings. So as opposed to like. Retuning a guitar, I just have a different guitar.
Interesting. So, you know, something you said earlier, actually, you mentioned the Muse. I would love it if you would talk more about that, relating specifically to your experience of being inspired.
I used to really question it all the time, like, why is this happening to me? And I just decided to be more, I don't know if it's an Eastern philosophy, just accept that it does. Because I know other people that don't have the kind of output that I do, and I'm not looking down on those people if you're one of them.
No.
Some people take longer to do things, and some people do it really fast. I know a couple of people, Erie Locke, I don't know if you know that guy, was in the band Lux for a while, and I think he has 3 active bands right now that all have the same members, I believe, or close to the same members. But the dude outputs probably equal or more than I do.
Wow.
Constant rate, puts it out. Crazy. So props to him. But I think for me, it's just a matter of being open to it. You know, it's more or less anytime I get a guitar. So my girlfriend and I have been working on this house and this room and trying to get everything ready. And so I really haven't been working on music. It's like the first time in my life that I think I haven't written a song probably in a month now.
Oh my gosh. Well, that's a long time for you, isn't it?
Totally. My output seems to average between, I want to say, 30 and 50 songs a year. And I've been doing it since I was 15. And
oh, my gosh.
Now.
Wow.
It's a lot. And I try to keep track of it at points, go through hard drives and figure it out, write down things, and then give up after a couple hours. I don't know. So for me, it's if I just sit down and I have a guitar, something will happen. I don't know.
You're just channeling.
It's hard to explain why, and I don't want to question it anymore. I just let it happen. I'm open to that happening. I've also learned some other techniques that other people that don't have that sort of open channel can work on to help them. The thing that we were talking about having something nearby.
Right.
You can always sing it into your phone, even if it doesn't make any sense later on. You were creative and you expressed your creativity for a couple minutes.
I love that.
You could write down a lyric. It doesn't have to be a whole hype. It doesn't have to be a whole it doesn't have to be a whole song. It could be one line. It could be, I've got a couple things on here that are just you know, one thing. I think I have one that I've been sitting here, a text file, for like 3 years, and the only line says the bloom is off the rose.
But it's going to turn into something.
That's a good title. I can
it's
write.
It's a really good one.
Sure, but
yeah.
I haven't. I don't know why. It just hasn't happened, but it's still sitting on my hard drive.
Well, it's waiting. You know what? I've had things that have sat around for years too.
Hit me up.
Okay.
So, you know, and then I have a whole lot of stuff that's undone. Like I said, so it's just a matter of getting it down. Whether or not it's like most of my stuff, like I said, is guitar based. And then I'll put drums to it and bass and keyboards and whatever else is going to go. So music, 95% of the time happens for me first, and then lyrics and melody lines come later on. That's a lot harder for me because I'm so geared up to get training out music for the other thing that I've been doing.
Right.
It's just easy for me to just whip out music and not have any vocals going to it. Or, you know, I still set them up like they're ready for vocals, but I don't know.
Yeah. All right.
So being open to it, you can try some techniques. So you can set, I tried this before when it works. You can set an egg timer, let's say for 10 minutes, put it on your desk and you set it and you start writing. You can only write for the 10 minutes though. As soon as it dings, you have to put your pen down no matter where you're at. That's it for the day. Tomorrow, same exact time. You got to do it at the same time every day though.
Really? Oh, so you're training yourself. Is that it?
Yeah. So this becomes a challenge that when you're actually creative and you have 10 minutes to spare, you know what your tools are. You can get to your tools really quickly. You can get everything up and running really quickly. And then the idea is there. Boom. You just run through it. And then whatever you're doing with it after that, save it. It doesn't go anywhere. You write one stanza, you write one riff, one verse, one chord, whatever. Or maybe you write a whole song. You know, that's happened to me before. Some of the best songs I have, you know, I started out with an idea, I kept running. 2 hours later, I've got a whole production. I'm sending people in the respective groups that I'm working with and going, hey, what do you think about this? You got any ideas? I'll give you a mix that doesn't have the second guitar part in it. You can come up with another idea.
Huh.
So
you believe in collaboration. That's what I'm hearing. That sounds really cool.
Yeah. So a lot of times, I'll have a whole idea and maybe I won't give people that I'm thinking, this is good for this group. I'll give them the song without a part in it. Mm-hmm. So like the drums, I've got them all clicked out. So I won't give the drummer a drum track. I'll just give them a click. It's got 8 counts to bring the song in. And then, go ahead. When this is done, in this corner where the guitars are, I have an electric drum set. It hooks right up to the computer. So we can record the drums right here. We can record the guitars right here. We can record everything right here.
Nice.
And, you know, drummer could come in and play on that kit. Or if they've got an electric kit that they've got a program, they can take the track and import it at home and send me the track. I could be like Steely Dan. I could get 5 drummers to give me 5 different versions of the same exact song. And then pick and choose. This guy's chorus, like this guy's verse, or whatever, gal, maybe. So there's also a website, I think it's still active, it's called Indaba Music.com.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a collaboration website. That is what they do. So you do exactly what I just said. You put the skeleton of a song up there and you say, I'm looking for a guitar player, singer, put some lyrics to this or what have you. And so I went on that. Somebody told me about that site. I went on that site a couple years back and looking at songs that need this or that or the other thing. I hear something I like and I ask if I can participate. They give me access to the stems and the downloads and it says, this is 130 beats a minute. It's in B minor. So you kind of have, you know, a parameter. Make sure my hands are on the screen there. A parameter to work within of some nature. And then you do something. The most recent one I did was a country song. This guy had up, and he was asking for all these collaborators. And I listened to the song, and I was like, if there's anything this song needs, it's great. The only thing I could think of is maybe some harmony parts, some vocals.
Yeah.
Well, do you want to write them? I said, okay. So I wrote them. I sang them, sent them, and I even sent them a thing saying, you know, I, as a producer, I believe it's always best for the vocalist to sing these parts, not me or some other vocalist. And he said, is that going to be okay with you if I do? I'm like, of course. I just said so. So anyway, the guy's shopping the song around with
how cool is that?
Right now.
Yeah.
Allegedly got some bites. The song is going to happen. He gave me a 10% songwriting credit for just putting vocal harmony.
Oh, that's so cool. Well, actually, that reminds me.
I don't know if it'll turn into money.
Who knows? But it could. But speaking of money, I know that you do a lot of commercial licensing of your music as well. So you're very often doing that kind. I'm very interested to know more about that.
Not so much lately because of everything else that's going on. But right. I've been a lot more active. And I think that the competition is getting a lot harder and people are getting a lot tighter on budgets.
Do you think it's partly because of the whole digital thing? It's just brought it so much more accessible to people? Music is more accessible in how to create it?
Well, they're a couple hour long topic, but
yeah, definitely.
In a way, probably for you and the things that you do with photography and creative work, there's a lot of people willing to do things for free.
Yeah, true.
For really, really cheap money. There's the whole Fiverr idea, you know?
Oh, yeah.
And I just don't work that way. You know, I want to get paid for things that I do. If you're going to use my stuff and you're going to make money off of it, that'd be totally different if you weren't making any money off of it, you know? Like with other songwriters, I've collaborated with other people and I've asked them for a percentage. If nothing ever happens, 25% of nothing is nothing. You know, there's no loss for them. If they make money, why wouldn't they give me some of it? You know?
Yeah.
So in the realm of licensing, though, it's really hard to get into, and I just happen to get lucky and get into it through some other people. And then just kind of try to maintain the contacts every time. Not been so good about it recently, but...
You don't need to tell us that. It's okay.
Edit that part. But yeah, so I think if anybody wants to get into it, there are sites out there that are for people that want to try to do that kind of work. Most of them charge money, though.
Yeah.
I'm not into that either. I talked to your husband about that a little bit. Like, you can go on these sites and you could pay $50 to or $25 to submit your song along with 1,000 other people.
Right. Right.
Or you could try to figure it out, you know?
Yeah. But here's the bottom line. All of us creative types who want to share with the world, right? We're just looking for a place. We're just looking for a person that our creativity can land on, you know, so people appreciate it. And I don't know, maybe that's what I want to ask you about that now. What's that like for you when you're actually performing and people are really responsive? I would love to hear how that makes you feel.
It's really great. I mean, there's not much else that's like that. And maybe you've had that with these things I see in the background on there, you know, with people looking at your pictures or your portraitures.
Yeah, sure.
And they're like, oh man, that touches me so much. And you're like, oh yeah. You're like, yeah, keep it going.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's so good to be able to have that. And especially when other artists respond to it, you know, the band that I was in for a little while called Drone, we had this song out called This Time, and it made it on a bunch of radio stations and whatnot. But right after it was done, a couple of people that were in local bands, and people just don't do this. Generally speaking, musicians are kind of a not so easy with compliments about other people.
Okay.
But somebody says, you know, that song, I've been humming it for the last couple of days, man. That hook is so good.
Yeah, the hooks.
Yes.
It makes a great song, doesn't it?
If it's another player, if it's another songwriter that's saying that, it makes it even more.
Yeah.
Not the general audience, you know, but it's great when you look out and you see people singing a song that you wrote, that you poured yourself into, that you got your band members on board with. And they
Gosh. Well, I'll tell you what, Steve.
That's the creative process of the band world. So for me, it's been mostly me. I won't say that no other people contributed, but mostly me and then the other guys or gals come in and they put in their part into the stew, and then at that point if they're into it, then it moves to the next stage. That's why so many things don't make it, because I'm writing 100 songs and we can only do 20 of them, maybe,
right?
You know, so they get to be the first filter. Whoever I'm working with, they get to be the very first filter, and they go, they don't say this one's bad, they just go, I like this one.
Yeah,
I don't even know if they like any of the other ones. They just
pick something.
I like this one, let's do this one. And three or four other people engaged go, well, I like that one too. Okay, so then that one becomes a priority, and the other ones go away. You know, you know the guys in Tesla. My point there.
Oh yeah.
That they had written, I think that one, I want to say it was the Bust a Nut record. I think it wound up having like 12 or 13 songs on it, which is typical. And I believe that they said they wrote 40 or 50 songs for that. I know the guys in Seven Dust typically write 40 to 60 songs for the dozen that are going to make it on their record. So. Anything I would say to anybody who's an aspiring songwriter, if you're even one at the level I'm at or even higher, that's the thing, man. Just write all the time. Like I said, get this creative process in check that you can do it really quickly.
Yeah.
Know how, because, you know, the once-in-a-lifetime song, it's still going to be once-in-a-lifetime.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime.
But you're going to know how to capture it. It won't go out the door.
So like, sleep with your iPad under your pillow. Awesome. Steve, thank you so much.
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah, get that studio up. Listen, there is so much to talk about with you around this subject. I love it. And if you don't mind, chances are I'm going to hit you back up again.
Part two.
Absolutely. So, and the one question I didn't ask you, we don't have too much time, but the one other question I didn't ask you was, what genre? What's your musical genre? How would you define it? Can you define it?
Primarily, I write hard rock music.
There you go.
Oriented hard rock. I want to say guitar riff oriented hard rock.
Yeah.
But like I said, I'm playing in a couple cover bands now. I just got hit up to play bass for this country thing. I sat in with a country band a couple times.
Well, that's fun.
Play guitar.
Yeah.
I don't care.
You don't care? You just want to make music and have fun.
I just like playing. And if people want to pay me for it, even better.
There you go. There you go. All right. Well, thank you. I so appreciate your time. It's very interesting, some of the stuff you said. And like I said, we're going to hit you up for part two next time. So, Steve, thank you very much. Keep writing. Next time, I'm hoping you'll do a little playing for me too. All right?
All right.
All right. Take care. Bye. Thank you. Oh, hey, if somebody wants to find you, how do they find you? You're working on a website, or do they find you on Facebook or MySpace, or what? How do they find you?
There's a Steve Mahoney Music page on Facebook, and there's stevemahoneymusic.com, which is up and running.
Okay, good. That's where we'll go. stevemahoney.com.
stevemahoneymusic.com.
stevemahoneymusic.com. All right. I will not mess that up because I'll put a link.
Oh, cool.
I'll put a link to your site there for you.
That's the page that's going to say Steve's doing this band this week. And Steve's doing this band.
Oh, my. Yes, they can see what a whirlwind you are of activity. My goodness.
Junk is happening.
Well, thank you again. We'll talk soon. Yeah. Okay, Steve. Take care. Bye. Don't go away. I'm still here.
I know.
Okay, good. Oh, now he pulls out his guitar.
Well, I was just wondering why this guitar wasn't in tune a second ago.
Oh, man. No, I'm serious. I do want to do a part two with you. I would love to do a part two with you where you're actually creating something on the spot, and I bet you could. You could do a 10, like that 10, like here, we're doing the 10 minutes. Like, do the 10-minute thing. I think that'd be awesome, don't you?
No, you're right. It would.
Yeah. So I want to schedule that with you. I want to schedule a 10-minute, you know, working with Steve, you know, Steve's 10-minute
sidebar
music, whatever. Okay. So I've got my calendar out. How about, it's a little ways off, but I'm thinking like the third week of March.
As long as it's not Friday the 17th.
Nope. I was thinking Friday the 24th.
Oh, that'd probably be all right.
Can you do Friday the 24th?
Yeah, I don't see why not.
Okay, great. What time?
Same time.
6 p.m. I normally wouldn't have done it. Tonight something came up that I couldn't avoid. And but I think 6 p.m. is good, right? Okay, so Steve Mahoney. The 10-minute timer. Making music. Okay?
Oh, this is terrible.
So have your guitar tuned.
I didn't have. I was trying to get everything prepared. I was going to show you how it goes.
Oh, man.
I had a song that was already done, but I could just pretend I was doing it.
Well, you know what? Then let's just do it.
Let me ask you this, though.
Yeah.
If I play this, does it come through?
Let me hear. Oh, yeah, it comes through. Yeah. Yeah, it comes through. All right, I tell you what. If you don't mind, I'm just going to go ahead and start over again and say, hi, I'm Char. We're back with Steve Mahoney, blah, blah, blah. Okay? And then you're going to do something. I don't know. But we're going to keep it short and sweet. All right? Again, we're just going to keep it to a really short and sweet. We'll just do a part two. And say, we're here with Steve. He's agreed to, you know, try to create on the spot. All right? You ready? Okay. We're going to wait. Are you able to hear me, by the way?
Yep.
I know you were having a little bit of trouble earlier until you turned your sound up, right?
I have my speakers turned up.
Okay, good. But you can hear me now.
Yeah,
don't tell anybody that. They don't need to know. You ready? Scoop back just a tiny little bit so I can see you just a little bit better.
One more little adjustment I gotta make because I don't have a plectrum right here.
Okay.
Whoops.
I know, so demanding.
Don't fall over, please. Thank you. Of course not. I don't even know where I put my guitar picks from the show the other day.
Oh no.
Grab a penny. I'll use a penny.
You're gonna use a penny as a guitar pick?
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
Is it?
Yeah, it is funny.
Okay. Let's get this riff here. That's not the riff. That's a different riff.
Sorry, I was just sending something to somebody. He's getting his guitar tuned. Oh. Chris is here. It looks like Chris looks like a cat, but he really is here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you. I just don't have the screen out right now.
He doesn't have the screen up. He's doing something else right now.
Being covered by guitar amps right now.
Oh, we are recording. Thanks, honey. Okay, we got to make sure that that stays in its spot, though. Okay? Very important. Thank you. Actually, it's... Shoot. This is all on tape. You know that, these crazy faces and everything.
I hear you.
Can you see me?
Where's the video at?
I don't know. Hang on. Let me look. Oh, no, I'm still here.
Ah! There's a picture of you now. There you are. Okay.
Okay.
That was crazy. So weird.
Hang on. Get this all straightened out here.
Program and you.
Okay, so I'm going to literally put on a 10-minute timer for you.
Oh my goodness.
Well, why not? Okay, so when I say, okay, go, and then you're going to go, I'm going to let you do your thing, okay? Tell me when you're ready.
Okay, got to make that noise stop. Okay, 10 minutes, right?
You got 10 minutes. I'm going to introduce myself. I'm going to introduce you. Yeah, do anything you want in 10 minutes, okay? Have fun. Have fun. Write a song. Scoot back a little bit so I can see you just a little bit better. Okay, good. There you go. You ready? All right. So hang on. Let me do my thing. Just, you know, paper, whatever. Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm Char Crail, Focus on Creativity, and we are back with Steve Mahoney, the amazing singer-songwriter. He's so prolific. And he told us last time we talked that he had a technique for getting a song, at least, you know, creating something out of nowhere in 10 minutes. He's going to prove it right now. I'm going to time him. I've got my timer here, and we've got 10 minutes. So here we go. On your mark, get set, go.
Okay, so first, you're going to start with something. In this case, it's going to be everything goes like this. So I know how fast it goes. I set a timer. So there's the click. I don't know if you can hear that.
Oh yeah.
And then you record that part. Okay, there's one. And because this is a program that you can repeat, you can just save that and use it later on when that part comes around again. And I'm gonna find another part. That thing. That second again.
So you're working in GarageBand right now?
Yep.
Cool. So you're recording it, so you can loop it later. Okay, got it.
There's the recording. There's the click. So I might record that riff with the second guitar and then add some bass later on. Right now, for the purpose of creating, I'm going to go to the next part. So the next part is sort of similar to the first part.
So what made you pick that beat?
Well, like I said, I just started off with the guitar playing that riff, and then I figured out how fast it was by setting the metronome to it. In this case, it's 150 beats per minute.
Nice.
So I set my timer to 150. That way, when I get to the part where I'm going to start writing drums for these, I'll have it synced up in time. I'm not just
freestyling.
So the next part is similar to the first part. Okay. variation on what I played before. Do something different. And then let's see, somewhere down the line here, I believe there's some section that's set up for guitar solo noodling.
Guitar solo noodling. That sounds really fun.
So this all comes about later on. There's another guitar part that comes up here later on that I already pre-recorded. Doesn't even sound like it fit with that first part at all. So now we got a verse, we got a chorus, and we got a bridge. There's a whole.
Oh my God! You have a really all those three things in that little tiny bit of time?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
But then you just take that and take it apart, and so with this program you can copy and make things loop. Wow. So if the first guitar part sounded good, I can go ahead and keep that, and I can loop it later on, or just copy the whole section to another section. Verse goes here, verse goes there, and so it's good for arranging too. So if I'm going to work with another person, they go, can I have that 8 times? You only played it 4. Well, guess what? I just go, bloop, 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 bloop.
Wow.
Bye. There's your 8 times, buddy. Write some lyrics.
Are you going to write lyrics too?
Eventually, I'm sure there'll be some lyrics.
Today, I was thinking, because, we still got 5 minutes and 41, 0, 39,
I don't 38. For this right the second, but if somebody wants to write some,
Well, they can go to that website you mentioned.
Then we go to the drum track. We'll get rid of the click. And then I'll start writing drums for these same exact parts. So here comes that.
You look happy. Oh yeah, that's headbanging music, all right.
Now that's the first part. Blah 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 blah. More blah. Okay. So this becomes a template that I can sit here and listen to this and I go, what's the timing? I don't want to do this. If I'm singing, I gotta make sure I can do this at the same time too. Not so fast. Not so fast. So that same stuff repeats itself over again.
Wow. And where are we at? We're at 358. Oh, that's nice. Is that you? What are you going to title it?
How long was that? This song did have some lyrics to it before, kind of on the scrap. So it was being called Fight. Right now it's called June 27th.
That's a very catchy name.
That was when the first riff happened. So,
okay, got it.
Like I said, some of them are quick, some of them aren't so quick. That's the one that's not so quick.
All right, so what I got was that you actually created some of that earlier, and then you're combining them. You felt that they went together, so you put them together. Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Great.
So, here's my template. So, I got a template that, I just opened up the template. And so,
oh, my gosh. Now I get it.
The guitar part, turn it on. My guitar's ready to rock right now. And I go to the drum kit. and I have the drum kit already. There's some basic beats. I'm using Superior Drummer, by the way, if anybody wants to know.
So these are beats. These are loops. These are essentially the beats that have already been created.
So you have your basic beat, right? Like this is AC/DC 101. This will pretty much be what I start every single song I write.
Really?
Yeah. You know, because there's no way you can mess that up.
All right, how are we doing? All right, we're counting down now. 141.
What? I don't have
39, 38, 37.
Well, that's no fun.
Just over a minute now. Minute and a half,
all right,
roughly.
Let's see if I can get rid of this track here. Go all the way to the beginning. Loop. Okay.
Look, I'm gonna say, I know you're not trying to write a song from beginning to end in 10 minutes, because the idea was around being creative and actually getting something in 10 minutes inspired.
In a row.
Awesome. Well, guess what? We've only got 19, 18, 17. We're almost there to our 10-second countdown.
With my 19 seconds or whatever that you just gave to me, I could theoretically cut and part each one of those little pieces and call this the part one, part two, and part three, and then replicate them and say, that's a song.
Look at that. Here we go. Woo! Good job. You did it. That was pretty awesome. And very interesting, actually, to watch the process. Yeah. But I do feel like I got a sense of it. I really do. It's pieces. It's bits and pieces. Some are being created on the spot. Some were actually created because, you know, we live in this amazing digital realm, right? And so you're taking pieces, you're putting them together, figuring out the order, figuring out the beat, and also creating from nothing, you know, like your inspiration as well.
I had that one the first part already pre-done, like, so just to save time. But the second thing I just did, that was just kind of off the top of my head.
Nice.
So there's a little piece of the chorus there.
I just have one last question for you, Steve. Aw, thank you. What occurred to me was, if there was anything in the world, is there anything in the world that you would do other than what you're doing? If given the chance or choice.
If I hit the lotto?
Yeah, sure. What'd you do if they hit the lotto?
I'm on vacation.
But you wouldn't stop making music, or would you?
I'd probably. Too busy.
Didn't expect that. Did not expect that.
World. Yeah, I know.
You'd be too busy traveling the world.
Let's go to Rome.
Go to Rome in Rome.
Why not? I don't know. I'll probably have a guitar with me. Who knows? I thought about, I never really thought about quitting until my mom passed a couple years ago. So I was kind of down. I thought, well, maybe I don't want to do this anymore. But you just can't get it out of your system, unfortunately. Yes.
Weren't you kind of born a musician? Born this way?
That's kind of how it seems. Can't seem to get rid of it. You know, I think there's a lot of people like you who are, they're lifers. You know, I call them lifers. You have the people who you see them playing, and they're maybe people that are 10, 20, 30 years older than I am. They're up in retirement age even, and they're still playing.
Yeah.
They're still having fun. And you're like, man, those people are laughers. And you have people who get into it for a little while, and then it's too hard, or, you know, it's too much. They get other responsibilities, or distract them from be creative or having fun with art.
I think you're a lifer too.
My mom was an oil painter, so I said she got it.
Yeah.
With me. She understood. And when, you know, and when the time came that I actually made a little bit of money doing it, she was like,
hey.
All right. Nice. You're not the way to do this, you know?
Oh, I love it. Right.
Yeah. So I don't think she would have wanted me to stop, honestly. So not necessarily doing it for her, but there's a little bit of that.
Sure. I know. I relate to that because my parents were both very creative people. So, and I see that. I see myself in, you know, I see them in me, in my expression and who I am and what I do.
Side topic on that. Do you think that inspiring creativity in younger people inspires more creative people in an overall sense? And specifically, if you have a child, your husband's a piano player, singer, and you're an artist in multiple ways.
Yeah.
This, if you had a child, it'd be totally ingrained in all that stuff.
Absolutely.
Pretty guaranteed they'd come out being an artist of some nature.
Well, either being an artist or in general, I would say being a creative thinker, which I think is super important. Because I believe we're all creative anyway, but what we're talking about is the arts. Am I right? But there's so many more ways to be creative, you know, and how you express yourself, and it could just be your own personal style, or it could be mathematics. I mean, there's so much creativity in all walks of life. But I do think that it helps to sort of think outside the box if you know, as parents and having kids, you know, just helping them to think for themselves and to believe in what their instincts are, their creative instincts. I think that's super important.
You grew up, and I grew up in an English-speaking country, and so we learned how to speak English. And if you had parents that were multilingual, you would have grown up multilingual.
Yeah, you probably would.
But you grew up in a universe where your parents have, let's say, the vocabulary of music,
yeah,
or the vocabulary of photography.
Yeah.
That becomes part of your vocabulary as you're learning the rest of life. You know, it's got to be there.
Yeah.
That's why when, you know, you and I were both involved in some capacity in Stairway to Stardom, I enjoyed that so much because it's like,
that's an amazing program.
Like,
yeah. So, oh my gosh, yes, absolutely. Inspiring young minds and showing them what's possible and helping them beat back what they think are their limitations, because there really aren't. I don't think so. Anyway, okay. Well, that ends our 10 minutes of amazing music writing with Steve Mahoney. Thank you again. If you want to find Steve Mahoney online, just go to stevemahoneymusic.com and I'll give you a link. And that was wonderful. I so appreciate getting to see the creative in action like that. Yay.
Cool.
Thank you, Steve. All right. Take care. We are complete.
Listen
to that
riff again.
Yay. Damn it.
I got something out of that.
I know, right? I got you to create something right on the spot there. Beautiful. All right, darling. Well, thank you. I will be posting these by the end of March. They're all going up wherever they're going, and I'm going to be sending them out like crazy. Please share away like crazy. I'll send you the link or the embed link if you want to put it on your website. And I'm glad we had this opportunity to do this together. Thank you.
Me too.
Yeah. And we really are complete, so I'm going to let you go. All right, Steve, let's stay in touch. We're on Facebook together, for goodness sakes. We should say hey more often. I miss talking to you.
Same happens.
Bye. Okay. I love it. Bye. Keep going.